Hey guys, before we start, I want to tell you really quick, if you want to support the channel and if you want a really cool t-shirt, you have until November 22nd to get your awesome John's Arcade t-shirt. Go to teespring.com/John's Arcade, the number 2, teespring.com/John's Arcade 2. Links are below. All right, let's get on with the show. Hey guys, we are in the basement, and today, yes, today guys, we're gonna play games. Yeah, yeah, we're gonna hang out and we're gonna play some arcade games, but you know what? The games that we're gonna play, they're not down here. No, we're not gonna play any of these games down here because we're gonna go upstairs and we're gonna play some obscure games, maybe some games that you've never heard of. Yes, yes, we're gonna play some of my favorite MAME games. I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. So we're gonna go upstairs, we're gonna hang out, we're gonna boot up the Miss Pac-Man MAME cabinet, and I'm gonna show you guys some, not all, of my favorite MAME games, and I think it's gonna be a lot of fun. But before we go upstairs though, I do need to announce that we have a winner, okay? We did a raffle for this. This is my Journey Restoration on 12 DVDs, okay? It's over 20 hours of footage. It really is the complete documentation of my Journey arcade restoration, and one of my viewers, C. Bart, put this together. He made these by hand, okay? He made 3 of them, and he did an amazing job. We gave away 1 at Grinker's. I have 1 for myself, and then we're giving away this one right here in this raffle that we just finished, okay? Now, I've already emailed the winner, but I wanna let you guys know who it is, because it's Kaylin, okay? It's Kaylin Van in Australia, okay? And what's cool about Kaylin winning, though, is that he actually just sent me this poster a few days ago. So Kaylin is a true fan, okay? Because Kaylin made me this little John's Arcade poster, and we talked about this. This is a pure coincidence. We talked about this a few episodes ago, and he's the one that won the raffle. So Kaylin, congratulations. I'm gonna mail this out this week, so you should probably get it in about 10 days or so because you're down in Australia. But again, Kaylin, congratulations, and thanks to everyone that entered the raffle, and that's it. So the raffle's over, but we might do another raffle soon because I have that LG phone I want to give away, and that's a really great prize. But anyway, congrats to Kaylin, and thanks to C. Bart for making these awesome, one-of-a-kind, handmade box sets. Truly an awesome thing, and I'm going to autograph every one of these discs, including the box. So anyway, enough of that. Guys, let's go upstairs and let's play some games in MAME. I think this is going to be kind of fun and a little different. So, all right, let's go upstairs, and I'm going to show you guys some of my favorite games in MAME. All right, guys, we are upstairs, and you know, I thought we'd play some games on the Miss Pac-Man MAME cabinet. And yes, this is a MAME cabinet. This is an original Bally Midway Miss Pac, you know, from 1981, and it's in pretty good shape. And what I did was this. I got myself a Pac-Man to JAMA adapter, right? And I just plugged it into the harness. So I didn't have to hack up the harness. It's all original inside. And I took that JAMA adapter and I plugged it into a JPAC that then goes to a PC. So I can easily convert it back to the original, you know, PCB and all that in about 30 seconds, okay? And then what I also did was I picked up a reproduction control panel from Mike's Arcade that has 2 buttons, okay? Okay, and I wired those buttons into the JAMA harness. So essentially what I have here is a vertical MAME cabinet with a 4-way original Midway joystick and then 2 buttons. And that really allows me to play most classics that I really like. You know, your Dig Dugs, your Pac-Mans, Galaga, Galaxian, you know, stuff like that, okay? So anyway, I thought we'd play some games up here. Let's do something different and just hang out up here for a little bit. I do really like this setup because it's very versatile and it lets me try games, you know, before I get them and bring them into the basement. And it also lets me play some obscure stuff that maybe I would never be able to own. So anyway, right now it's booted into Miss Pac, and I have a custom Mala theme that I created. Yeah, the front end I'm using is called Mala. And so if we go ahead and press the 1 and 2 player buttons right here, which is essentially escape. I pressed them, damn it. So if you press it twice, it wants to shut down, once to the menu and then again to shut down. Anyway, here's the menu system. And I actually made this available to download. If you go to johnsarcade.com, you can download my Mala theme. But right now we're in popular games, and it basically keeps track how many times you start the game. Not how many times you play the game, but how many times the game is booted in MAME. So you can see that Ms. Pac-Man has been booted 172 times, which is actually quite a bit, you know. Because if I turn this game on, you know, 30 times a year, you know, which is probably about right. Yeah, probably turn it on, you know, a couple times a month up here. These games up here are not on, like, the basement. You know, the basement goes on a couple times a week. But anyway, so Ms. Pac-Man's been booted 172 times. Second, it's kind of funny, though. The most popular game on this MAME cabinet is Ms. Pac-Man. So second is Pac-Man, then Galaga, and then Armored Car, which I want to play right now. Armored Car is awesome, okay? This is a Stern classic. It's really obscure. I played this game the first time at the Fun Spot tournament a bunch of years ago, and I fell in love with this game, and it plays great in MAME. And I was actually going to get an Armored Car. I actually had a lead on one down in Pennsylvania, and I just kind of wimped out and didn't want to drive down there, so I never got my Armored Car, but someday I'm going to get an Armored Car. But anyway, for now, why don't we play it in MAME, because it's a pretty neat game. So let's start it up. You just press the one-player button. And this game, I don't think the resolution is quite right. It's a little compressed, but it's still very playable. You could see the blue here. I might be able to fix that. But for now, let's just leave it. So I'm gonna coin up. We're gonna press one player and start, and that's how you coin up. All right, and then let's start a game here. And so the object of the game here is to drive your little car around and pick up the money symbols, right? And then one of the buttons is a gas, and there's a key right here, and we want that because it's a bonus. We want to get the key and the lock. And so you look on the bottom here, there's a fuel gauge. And so we're driving around trying to get fuel, and then we have to be aware of our gas. And we could drop sawhorses like that. And see those arrows? You can only go the direction they show. So if you go over a left-right arrow, you have to continue going left or right. You cannot go up and down. All right, so let's go around here, and let's get as many of these money bags as we can. And so up here is the lock. We already got the key, so let's get the lock. So we just got a nice little bonus. And I usually race around. Here's gas. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to collect as many of these money bags as we can, and then we're gonna drop them off at the bank, okay? And we're just trying to avoid everybody. So I dropped a sawhorse there. So let's get the lock. Drop a sawhorse, kills that guy. So we're about to run out of gas. Let's keep the gas right here. All right. So we got to, you know, so the left, right arrow, up, down, the arrows change. So right there, I can't go left or right. Now it changed to left and right, and I can. There's the lock. I know this game probably looks lame, but when you play it for high score, it's actually quite fun. Ran out of gas. So when you run out of gas, your car just goes real slow. It doesn't stop. So let's keep collecting these money things. Oh my God, we gotta at least make it to the bank here. All right, I'm gonna play for real. Let's get to the bank. I'm just kinda going fast now because I wanna make it to the bank and cash in our dough. Let's get the lock. So here's the bank right here. It's coming up. All right, so we dropped all of our money bags, our money symbols into the bank. We get 100 points for each one. And then we get a bonus sawhorse for every four monies, it says. All right, so, I mean, this is the game, all right? It's rinse and repeat, it gets harder, and it's simplistic, but it's really fun to play for high score. Now, I don't know if I ever got one of these games, would I get sick of it pretty quick? Probably. But when it's in a high score tournament, it's actually great. And I think we should put this in BroFest too, because like I said, FunSpot has one of these. So let's see, doing pretty okay. I definitely encourage you to boot this up into MAME though, it's fun. All right, let's go over here. Bank. And you can see on the bottom here our progress. I've never made it to the end. I don't know, I've gotten really close. I don't know what happens when you get to the end in this game. It's not easy to do. So you can see right now we're at the second little dot. So they start adding more stuff, like, you know, there's an ambulance right there. Oh shit, I died. So yeah, that's Armored Car. What do you think? It's different, you know, it's a game I guarantee you've never heard of. Just a kind of a rare, listen to that music. That's the same music that's in Domino, man. It's kind of okay in MAME. It's not emulated perfectly. All right, so let's go back to the menu. Let's play another game. There is one game I really want to play. Let's go back to my popular list. Dig Dug, yeah, we've all seen that. Journey, I love Mappy. Thief, we've talked about Thief before. Gyrus, actually, I think Thief has my audio in it. I don't remember. Let's see. I think my audio file's in here. Now, this is a horizontal game on a vertical monitor, so you can kind of see it smushes it, but it actually is totally playable. I'm wondering if this has my audio, because if you guys remember,
I... units in the vicinity of Hollywood and Vine.
Yeah, that's me.
Call 13. See the man at Doheny and Sunset. Use caution. Pursuit of robbers.
So in MAME, you can drop a WAV or MP3 file in the folder, the asset folder. I don't remember how I did it.
Units, use caution.
Officer, because this game originally had a cassette player.
Code 3.
That played that audio, and so it'll play a digital file instead in MAME.
And dangerous. Disabled vehicle on fountain.
Isn't that funny?
Need officer assistance to handle traffic. All four in progress. Proceed to Elm and Main. Code 3.
Dispatch, this is Car 2 in hot pursuit of sedan.
That's pretty good, right?
What is your location, Car 2?
Now proceeding south on Castle and Spring.
Get to the little effect on the voice. So yeah, that's Thief. You know, that's an okay game. I want to play Teddy Boy Blues because I love that game. So Gyrus and then that version of Ms. Pack. I got to figure out where I put Teddy Boy Blues. So we have different menus here. I have Best of Claw. A lot of these menus are, the titles are kind of meaningless now because I just keep dumping stuff into these folders. All right, Teddy Boy Blues is amazing. This is such a cool game, and if I ever find this PCB, I'm gonna jump on it. It's a weird Sega game, and I love it. My friend Craig has the PCB, and I need to get it from him. So what's going on here? It's doing a little boot sequence. So let's let this load. What is going on? All right, so it's doing a boot sequence. Now this is also a horizontal game that we're playing on a vertical monitor, but it actually looks pretty good. It's totally playable, the way it stretches the game. God, this boot, I don't remember this boot sequence being so long. I guess it is. So it's literally emulating the hardware. So that's exactly what it would do when you have the real PCB. So it's a Sega game. Look at this. It's so weird. This game is awesome. You have to play this game in MAME. Just trust me, it's great, great, great. All right, so let's play us a little bit of Teddy Boy Blues. All right, it's coin up. All right, so we're this little guy with this Uzi, right? And we're basically just going around and killing everybody. Music is great. And after you shoot the guys, they turn in these little babies and you pick up the babies. So, I believe the objective is to kill all the bad guys, right? I actually haven't played this in quite some time, but I love it. Oh. All right, so we got like one guy left here. Come here, dude. Don't All right, let's get his baby and get out of here. All right, so we cleared the level. I'm trying to remember. I think there's like some weird bonus level too. So we got this little monster house here. You know, I think Craig, like I said, Craig, my buddy Craig's got this PCB. I need to get it from him. Every now and then I look like on eBay for it, and you know, this is the kind of board you need to get like on Yahoo Japan. All right, so we cleared that level. All right, so bonus game. You want to do the boy or the girl? Let's do the girl. Welcome to the treasure room. Totally weird game, right? Enjoy treasure hunting. Yohika. All right, so I guess we go around here and we got to find stuff hidden. Should we look in the bed? Ah, under the pillow, there's money. All right, how about over here on the wall? There's a basketball hoop. No, let's go upstairs. Isn't this just crazy? Oh, I found some money there. Bookshelf. Oh, there's all kinds of money in the bookshelf. So that is the best bonus mode ever. You have to admit. All right. All right, so the bad guys are getting a little more complicated and tough. All right, I got like baby parts everywhere. I gotta get all these. Hurry up, oh, man, I'm running out of time. Where is the last bad guy? All right, so we ran out of time there. So I don't know if it's mandatory to pick up their parts after you kill them. I think you get a bonus for it. Not sure. Ah, overwhelmed. All right, gotta get their parts. Okay, we cleared that level. Definitely getting tough here. So let me see if I can shoot that monster house now. Oh, that was dumb. So yeah, I think that's it. We're game's over, but that is a really cool game. Definitely try Teddy Boy Blues. Wow, it's weird. Like, I mean, I've definitely gotten my name on the leaderboard before. It does seem like every now and then it loses the scores in this, which is totally bizarre to me. All right, let's go back to the menu. Let's see what else. I want to play Flicky. Let's see if that's in here. Oh, Rock and Rope is cool. Oh, that Psycho game is awesome. Let's play this. Psychic 5. This is another cool game. Dude, this just a lot of cool oddball games. And this game's kind of neat. I don't fully get how to do it. But it's kind of a cool game. All right, so this kid, he's got a hammer. You could switch characters. I don't remember how you do that. See down here? Oh, you have to find the other kids. So there's like five different characters you can play as, and they're on the map. They're on the level. And you got to find them. And they all have different abilities. Like the fat kid is, I think he has a stronger attack. I don't know if there's any point of getting... Alright, so we killed that dude. Of course he's coming back. All No. I gotta get up here. All right. It's an umbrella throwing rain at me. Ah! There we go. Oh, there's a trap door there. Trap floor. But this is like a weird game. I came across this one day and I'm like, what is this? And it's actually kind of cool. All right, so there's the fat kid. So we can be him now. How do we switch fat kids? I don't remember how I did that. Oh, in here. All right, let's be the, here's the fat kid. So he's real slow, but I think his attack is really strong. Yeah, see, he can kill that clock with one hit. But he's just too, so you go in the phone booth, and then you can press, let's be the girl. So I don't know if she can jump higher or something, I don't know. Ah, died. But yeah, it's a neat game. I don't really know what I'm doing. I really don't. Oh boy, definitely. I wonder if the fat kid can walk right through the fire. So yeah, that's, what's this game called again? It's like something X. See if we can see the title screen again. Yeah, whatever. It is called Psychic 5, that's right. Let's find Flicky though. Oh, Moonwalkers, I love, there's a lot of games in here I really like. Kung Fu. Here's Flicky. Flicky's fun. This is another Sega game. This was released by Bally Midway in the US. It was part of the six pack, they called it. It was in a generic cabinet that looked just like Journey or Bump and Jump, that profile, but it's a cool game. It's another one I haven't played in a while, but I gotta remember what to do. Oh, we gotta get all the birds. And then I guess drop them off there and avoid the cats. Oh. Hmm. Kind of reminds me of Mappy a little bit, just the way the level scrolls and with the platforms. So we've got this flower pot that we can throw at the cat. And the, I think the baby chicks are getting bigger. So I think it's a risk versus reward thing. You know, do you want to get them all now or? All right, let's drop them off. All right, I think we cleared the level, we did. Again, this is a horizontal game that plays just fine on a vertical cabinet. So, you know, I would encourage you to build a vertical cabinet because it does just fine with the most of the horizontal games, especially from this era. You know, I've never tried playing like, you know, Simpsons or Turtles on this. Just these kind of simplistic games. Mm. Oh. The cat can... Oh, you stupid cat. All right, let's get rid of these birds. Oh, no. Eek. All right. How'd I do that? All right, let's drop this off. Cat. What? Oh, I made it. Come on, you. Get in there. All right, level's cleared. All right, bonus round, we gotta catch them. All right, so we got 16 of the 20. It's a cute game, right? Oh no. That's cool. Definitely a cool game. So that's Flicky by SEGA. Another great one to try in MAME. Oh, what else can we try? Fantasy. Let's try one more game. This folder, Best of Clove, is just a bunch of games that I just threw in here. That Airbuster game, is that like a... No, that's not what I'm thinking of. Oh, let's play Anteater, because we were talking about that on the last episode. A guy wrote in and said he had an Anteater PCB. And I knew I had tried it in MAME at some point. So let's... I honestly don't know if I really played this, but... Okay, I already get it. So we gotta get... Oh my god. We gotta get to the bottom. And we gotta eat ants? Can we eat everything or what? Yes. Well, I'm guessing the blue bugs will kill us. So we're trying to get all the dots. What happened? The caterpillar ate my tongue? What happens if we eat him? Okay, you cannot eat the caterpillar. Don't try. Oh. Let's try that again. I'm not really sure how to play this. It's kind of a crude game. Oh, I see. Oh, wait, what do you do with him? It looks like you can't eat the worms. Ant times. I don't know about this game. Let's go down here and see if we can. What? How am I dying? Very strange game. Made by Tago. Yeah, I don't know about that one. Let's see, ant larva is 10 points, ant worm, 200 points, but how do you kill the worm? All right, we're trying this again. Push the button to retract the tongue. Eat the queen to destroy all the ants. When the sun goes down, the spider comes out. Sneak up behind the worm. You can eat the worm from behind. All right, here we go. We're gonna sneak up on him. What? Oh, the worm can't eat the ant? I don't know. Let's see. All right, let's sneak up on the worm. Ah, we got him. All right, let's sneak up on this dude. Okay, I get it. So the bugs can't touch your tongue. You have to eat it with the tip. I get it. And then that dude can walk through. This game's frustrating, guys. Alright, that's Anteater. Yeah, it's okay. I know it's rare, but it's okay. Alright, let's. You know what I do want to play? I want to play Super Pac-Man. Oh, sure. Ooh, you know what we should play? Sky Skipper. That would be a good one to play. I wonder if I have it on here in this playlist. Sheriff. Sky Skipper is a really obscure Nintendo game. Let me see if I have it in this playlist. We have to scroll all the way down. And it's an interesting game because it's got these cool characters. Like almost like Mario-esque, Donkey Kong-esque characters that that are just kind of forgotten and lost, and I think the characters kind of had some merit to them. All right, here we go. Sky Skipper. So this is a horizontal game. I haven't played this game in forever. This is like one of those games that like I knew it existed, I tried it out, but it's got this dude right here, the king, the queen, the joker, that guy. I mean, where are these guys? These guys should be in Smash Brothers, you know? These are these lost Nintendo characters. All right, so I gotta remember how to play this because I haven't tried this in probably 3 years. All right. And I suspect the, oh yeah, I remember there's like a map. Let's see, what am I doing here exactly? Gotta remember what to do. Oh, okay. Whoa, what the hell just happened? I know that I used to know how to play this because I've played it a few times and I figured it out. I got to remember what to do here. All right, so it looks like I have a bomb that I can drop on these dudes. All right, and then when I do that, it releases these guys. Do I want those guys? Are those guys good or bad? I don't know. All right, those guys are my friends. So I want to rescue them, and I got to keep those dudes down. Okay, and that just released, like, the queen. All right, so we got her. All right, how about this gesture, dude? All right, so when you kill the guys, these little card people come up. But this is just a weird game to me because it has, like, these little cartoony characters, and Nintendo didn't seem to have these kind of characters in video games until like Donkey Kong, because everything else was like a radar scope and Sheriff, which was really generic. But those look like some pretty flushed out little guys. I don't know what they are. Are they supposed to be apes? They have like headphones on? Alright. Whoa, he just threw something at me. Alright. Get this dude. Wow, these guys are throwing balls at me now. Whoa. Maybe we should land and get some fuel? I don't know if that's how this works. No. You will crash. But I don't know, man. This game is neat. I know that, oh my god. Nintendo Arcade in the UK is really trying to find one of these games. I don't know if he found the PCB or what. You know, he's got the upright and cocktail versions of Sheriff, and really nice guy. And he's trying to get every Nintendo game that's ever been made, and this one is like a mystery to him. I mean, obviously someone had the PCB at some point because they dumped it into MAME. God, what do we do up here? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Alright, so let's go through here. Totally a weird game. Alright, come on up. Okay, so I don't know what's going on. There's like four... Oh, we cleared the level. There's four clubs up there. So look at this. This is awesome. Look at that. What are these things? I mean, this is very... I don't know. There's some Donkey Kong stuff going on here. I don't know what it is exactly, but it's cool. It's very cool. Damn it. I'll escape. Get ready. Last plane. I'm not convinced the game is actually really good, but it's definitely neat. All right. Let's go over here. Drop a bomb on that dude. Looks like it's more of the same here. So yeah, I think we should stop. What'd you guys think? Do you guys like playing the MAME cabinet? Whoops. If I press the escape thing twice in a row it wants to shut the system down, and I have to quickly get out of it. But anyway, yeah, that was kind of fun, right? Just hanging out up here. Maybe we'll do more of this stuff this winter and just kind of play MAME games and just talk about weird, obscure games that just don't seem to exist, at least in my basement. But that was fun. I think of all the games we just played, I think that Teddy Boy Blues, that's the one that, like, I really want that PCB. I'm gonna get that. I mean, obviously, I would, if a Sky Skipper showed up, I would jump on that because I'm a Nintendo guy, but that Teddy Boy Blues seems obtainable. Like, it's possible to get it, but anyway. All right, so why don't we go back down to the basement? You guys want to do some viewer mail? We'll hang out for a little bit, and yeah, that was fun. All right, let's go back down to the basement. All right, guys, there you have it. What'd you think of that, huh? Is this maybe a new segment? where we go upstairs and play games in MAME that maybe you've never heard of, or games that maybe I've never tried before? I think it could be kind of fun. So let me know if there's a game or two that you want me to play, and maybe we can do that in a future video. It's a perfect little midweek video for me because nice and quick, short and sweet. So anyway, all right, let's do some viewer mail real quick and get out of here. And of course, I need to remind you guys that we are doing another Teespring t-shirt campaign. If you guys want to support the show and support me, please buy one of these shirts. And the shirts are super cool. You know, the front's got the John's Arcade logo. The back has an illustration my friend Scoots did. It's a kind of like a tattoo style. Hey guys, we're in the basement with the thumb and all that. So if you guys want to order a shirt, go to teespring.com/johnsarcade2. That's teespring.com/johnsarcade2. You have until November 22nd, and once these shirts are gone, that's it. So if you want to support me and the channel and everything we do here, please buy a shirt. Okay, alright, let's do this. First one here is from Jason Stark. And by the way, if you want to participate in the viewer mail segment, you need to email them to me at blkdog7@gmail.com. That's blkdog7@gmail.com. In the subject line, please put viewer mail. All right, this one's from Jason. Hey John, Jason here. I sent you a viewer mail, but you might have gotten erased or misplaced, so I'll send it again. I just wanted to say that I'm a huge fan of your videos, and also your videos have made me become a video game collector. Which brings my question to you, and wanted to know what good games are out there to put in my collection along with my Golden Tee Complete. He's got a Revolution X, which is that Aerosmith shooter, a Terminator 2, a Carn Evil, and a Lethal Enforcers. Wow, you got a lot of gun games. I had some thoughts and ideas, but I thought I would come to the master of arcade collecting. Well thanks, Jason. To please let me know what websites are good to go to and what games you think are the best for my collection. Have a great day, your friend Jason. P.S. I hope your Tron and Street Fighter gets fixed, and I hope I get to meet you in person very soon. All right, well, the Tron's fixed. We fixed that last week or a few days ago. My Street Fighter fixed itself. I still don't know what happened because, and I don't think I really covered this, did I? Because if you guys remember, the green was stuck on the monitor, and it like completely fixed itself. I didn't do anything to the Street Fighter, and it's working perfectly fine now, which is really strange. But Jason's asking me, you know, what game he should get next? What's a good game to collect? You know, Jason, that's a really hard question for me to answer for you because, you know, everyone has different tastes and likes, and, you know, what I collect, some other guys don't like, you know. So I'll tell you this, though, you know, when I first started collecting, the games I got first were the ones that I really remembered as a kid. You know, those were the games I went after right away, you know, because when I was a kid, Donkey Kong was my favorite game, and that was the one I wanted first. And then I'm like, oh my God, I need to get Ms. Pac-Man because I loved Ms. Pac-Man. And then I got like Mario Brothers because I love Mario and Nintendo. And then I was on like on a mission to get all the Nintendo games. But I did all of that because those are the games that I remembered and loved as a kid, and that's why I got that stuff. So, Jason, I think you need to sit down and figure out, you know, are you into gun games? Then maybe that's the road you want to go down. Maybe you want to be a gun game guy, you know. I'll tell you, my personal grail gun game is Point Blank 2. It's a Japanese Namco gun game. The cabinet is crazy cool. So that's one that John would go after. I don't know if it's one that Jason would go after. Now, I noticed, though, you don't have any classics. I suspect you're a little bit younger than me, or maybe a lot younger than me. Maybe you don't have nostalgia for Donkey Kong and Pac-Man. But that would be a good game to maybe one of those to add to your collection. Or maybe you want to get some kind of a little multi, you know. Maybe get the arcade SD board and you can play Pac-Man, Donkey Kong, and Dig Dug, and you'll have all those classics at your fingertips. But it sounds like you got a great collection going here. Golden Tee Complete is I love that. I'll never get rid of mine. The gun games, you know, I haven't been drawn to them. The one gun game I really remember playing when I was younger was Operation Wolf. I mean, that was like my gun game. And I'm worried, though, if I got one of those, that it's repetitive, right? And there's an ending. Does the game go on forever? I don't know. But still, Point Blank 2 is the one I'm drawn to. And Jason, maybe you want to get a classic or a fighting game. You don't have any get a Street Fighter. That's fun. And Street Fighter is a great cabinet to have because it's JAMA. So you can swap boards out, which is what I do with that. That's a very useful cabinet. So Jason, I hope I helped you out. And as far as websites to buy arcade games, you know, there's no like retailer I would ever recommend. It's, you know, you really gotta hunt this stuff down yourself. Craigslist, eBay, Clav, collectors, networking. You don't want to go to a retailer. You're gonna get hosed. You know, unless you got tons of money and you don't want to worry about stuff. But if you want to get your hands dirty and you want to learn how to fix this stuff, you gotta find it used on Craigslist and eBay and all that. All right, next one's from Robbie. Hi John, I have a question. About the Firefox Laserdisc drive, did you get it repaired or is it getting fixed? And also, how can I send you a letter or a package to your home? Because there's a convention down here in Texas. Your friend Robbie in Houston. P.S. Can you send an autographed T-shirt to me? Thank you. Okay, Robbie. Okay, so Franz, who is an older gentleman, a really old retired guy. I guess he used to work at Philips back in the day, and he used to work on Laserdisc players in the 80s, okay? And I found this guy, and I don't know how old he is. I suspect he's in his 80s. I don't know to be certain, but he has my Laserdisc player, and he's had it now for a while. And I am in communication with him on and off. I'm being very patient, and I'm trying not to bug him, because I know that he's retired, and he's just doing this just to do it, okay? And I don't want to put too much pressure on him. But I did email him this week to get an update. And he said, you know, he's this much, you know, every time I email him, it's almost fixed, it's almost fixed, it's almost fixed. The last email, and by the way, he sends me these very detailed technical emails about what the Laserdisc player is doing, like with his oscilloscope. It's very technical. It's over my head. But he told me the other day that he thinks it should be ready in 3 weeks, okay? That's 3 weeks. So I hope that's true. And if that is true, that means in about a month, I'll have a Firefox down here. So cross your fingers for me, Robbie, that I get that back and it's working and we can bring Firefox down here, because I am anxious to play it. Do I have an... You know, I do have a... I have an address that I get. I don't really put it like on YouTube, but I have a P.O. box, and I'll email it to you. But if you guys want that, you have to email me, and then I'll send it to you. And it's not a secret, but I'm not putting it on my YouTube channel. But people that ask for it, I'll give it to them. So email me if you want my P.O. box. And then he's asking me if I can send him an autographed T-shirt. You know what? I'm gonna do that for you, Robbie. I can't do this for everybody. I can't, okay? But, you know, I'm gonna start giving you guys stuff, okay? We're gonna do more raffles. And Robbie, I'm gonna send you a shirt, okay? I'll send you one of the new shirts, because I did order a few for myself to give away. And when I get those shirts, I will send one to you and I'll sign it first. So email me your shirt size and your address and I'll take care of that for you. I ordered large and extra large to give away, so I hope you're one of those. So I will make a note that you're gonna get a shirt. I only have one shirt left from the last Teespring campaign, and I think I'm gonna give it to my dad. I think, you know, my dad likes this YouTube channel, he does. I don't know if he's watching or how religiously he watches, but he does. So I have one shirt left from the last T-shirt campaign, and I'm gonna give that to my father when I see him in a few weeks. But anyway, all right, so next one here is from Jeffrey. Hey, John, I really enjoy your show. What is your top three seller's remorse games? Are you going to use an Ampliphone or a 6100 in your Quantum? I'm a longtime collector. I currently have 33 games. That's a great collection, including 9 cabarets, 2 pins, a sit-down, a cocktail, and 20 uprights. I recently got a chance to do some filming with Walter Day. That's cool. Would love it if you could share this video with your audience. Jeffrey Aller, his YouTube channel is Arcade Hollywood. And so if you guys want to see Jeffrey's video, it's a video of Free Play FX in Pennsylvania. And there's a segment in there with Walter Day. So go on YouTube and do a search for Arcade Hollywood. The video is called 1983 Star Wars Review with Walter Day. And seller's remorse games. Well, the one that always comes to mind is my baby Pac-Man. I want that back. I want a baby Pac-Man down here. I think the game's neat and weird and cool and hard and challenging. And so that is a game that is on my list. And if I find a baby Pac-Man for the right price and the right condition, I'm gonna buy one. I'm gonna get one. That's the plan. So that is one game that I miss. I don't really have any other regrets selling games. I've sold a bunch of games to keep the cycle of life down here going. And right now I'm at a crossroads where I have to make some decisions. I think I'm going to get rid of Asteroids Deluxe and maybe Super Breakout. I haven't decided yet. Now, those games I might not sell, though. I might keep them and just put them somewhere else. I might bring them to work. I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do with them. But I think those are the games that are going to leave the basement for now. I think they might stay in my collection and go somewhere else. I don't know if I'm ready to be a storage guy. I'm not paying for storage space, but you know, I could bring stuff to work. I could let friends borrow games. I don't know. We'll see. But as far as seller's remorse, I don't have too much. You know, if I were to build a museum, someday and have hundreds of games, there are definitely games I regret selling, like Discs of Tron, because if I were to have a museum, that should be in the museum, but I don't have it, because I sold it. Games like that, Missile Command is a game that I would have to reacquire, but I'm never going to have a museum, and this is my museum, and it can only hold 35 games, so I have to let stuff go. And so far, Baby Pac-Man's the only game that I really, really, really wish I still had and wish I could play because it's so different. So anyway, that's it, guys. We're done. I hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to check out my podcast, Video Game Outsiders at videogameoutsiders.com and Arcade Outsiders at arcadeoutsiders.com. Now, we were going to do an Arcade Outsiders this week, but Joe emailed or texted Sean and I saying he can't make it now. So I don't think we're doing a podcast this week. And next week is Thanksgiving, or whatever. We're gearing up for Thanksgiving, so I'm not sure. We might be able to do one next week. We'll see. I don't think one's happening this week. But anyway, go to arcadeoutsiders.com. When a show is going to happen, I will post on there how you can listen to it live. And of course, that episode will go into the feed. And of course, I do Video Game Outsiders every week on Tuesdays at riotcast.com. But other than that, I'll see you guys very soon. I think this weekend, we have a couple videos coming up. The iRobot. We're going to finish that up, and then also the Nintendo Versus reveal, because that game is going to be delivered this week, and I could show you guys finally what it was that we were making in the garage, and I'm kind of excited, so I hope you guys enjoy that when we do reveal that. So anyway, that's it. I'll see you guys very soon. Thanks for watching and all that stuff. Subscribe, like, tell your friends, leave comments. It all means a lot. You guys all rule. So, all right, guys, I'll see you very soon. Later, and bye.